Meanwhile, on the other coast, President Trump today led his Salute to America rally on the National Mall in Washington. The event, produced at the president's request, brought military hardware, service members, and thousands of tourists together, but it also sparked widespread criticism. CBS's Katherine Johnson has the story.
With fireworks and controversy, President Trump celebrated America's 243rd birthday his way.
Today we come together as one nation with this very special Salute to America.
The president's Salute to America 4th of July event in the nation's capital featured tanks and military vehicles, flyovers by the Navy's Blue Angels, pageantry and applause. All branches of the armed forces were on hand and hailed.
Our nation is stronger today than it ever was before.
President Trump's event generated days of advanced criticism from Democrats and others who accused him of politicizing Independence Day.
Dishonors our troops, dishonors our service members and veterans because it's really all about Trump.
It was marked by protests like this one Thursday in front of the White House.
The event still doesn't have a public price tag, but the flyovers alone cost tens of thousands of dollars an hour.
The president promised the expense would be well worth it for what he marketed as the show of a lifetime. In his speech, President Trump ran through more than two centuries of iconic moments in American history.
Exactly 50 years ago this month, the world watched in awe as Apollo 11 astronauts launched into space.
In the audience, he honored Clarence Henderson, who took part in a sit-in at a Greensboro, North Carolina Woolworth lunch counter in 1960, a moment many say began the civil rights movement. Katherine Johnson, CBS News, Washington.
President Trump, by the way, the first president in nearly 70 years to speak at the National Mall on Independence Day.